Guys, and welcome back to the channel. Now guys, the Meyeti Ala, the umbrella group for the Fulani herdsmen, has only one message and one message alone for the Fashionati family. The Fashionati family, of course, is the family of Funke Olakunrin, and you already know the storyline. So Meyeti Ala has only one message for this family, and that message is go and swivel. So go and swivel is what they are saying to the Fashionati family. So go and find a very nice tall tree, hang a rope on it, do like a swing and swing on it and swivel. So this is the message that Meyeti Ala has for the Fashionati family. So guys, I bring you this. Defend yourselves against ethnic militia groups in a manner that nobody would try such again. Meyeti Ala to herdsmen. So that's the message that the Meyeti Ala, the umbrella group for the herdsmen, is sending to their members. So again, the headline, defend yourselves against ethnic militia groups in a manner that nobody would try such again. And that is the message that Meyeti Ala is sending to the Fulani herdsmen. So now let's get into the body of the story. Meyeti Ala Kwata Huri, the body uniting Fulani herdsmen in the country, has told its members to defend itself against ethnic militia groups in a manner that nobody would try such again, following warnings that came after recent killings witnessed in various parts of the country. Speaking just a few days ago, after President Muhammadu Buhari asked Fulani herdsmen to ignore calls from northern elders to return to the north if they feel threatened in the south, the national secretary of the group, Saleh Al-Hassan, warned that governors in the southern parts of the country will be held responsible if any of their members was attacked. He said, "We are Nigerians and we have a history. Anybody that thinks that he can wake up and take on the Fulani pastoralist is making a grievous mistake. We are prepared to defend our fundamental human rights of movement in this country. They, the herdsmen, are Nigerians, so they are entitled to stay where they are. They should remain where they are and defend themselves against any ethnic militia and assert their citizenship in this country. The only thing we will say is that we will hold all the governors of those states responsible for their safety and security. But if any ethnic militia by any name attack our members, they should defend themselves in a manner that nobody would try such again. We have been saying it that people behind insecurity are not herders. Bandits are behind these killings. And if government is saying foreigners have infiltrated the herders, have they been arrested? And what is their nationality? Anybody that is trying to destabilize this country should be dealt with." On calls by some northern groups that they should vacate the southern parts of the country, Al-Hassan said, "Those so-called northern youths called coalition of northern groups should note that if because of their actions any herders is killed, we would first look at them before we go after our enemies. We are Nigerians and we're not going anywhere. Our attachment to the land is opportunistic. We don't farm the land. So if anybody is thinking that because he has cultivated the land in a particular place for long and he has rights there more than us, then we would ask where is the grazing area that the colonial masters created for us. Politicians can play their politics, but they should leave our people out of it, because it is the desperate politicians that are causing this confusion and they are looking for anything to hang it on. But we are watching them critically. If you threaten the herders, they react. They cannot be used for any political game, because we have our own way of defending ourselves. We hate injustice and we fight it. Anybody that thinks we can be squeezed is making a mistake. He added that grazing reserves that were carved out before the country's independence should be developed to serve their purpose and also end persistent clashes between herders and their host communities. When we begin to discuss the Nigerian question, we would ask where the grazing reserves are, because we know them and we have the records of where they are, he added. So here we have this Al Hassan character yet again, coming out yet again to beat the drum beat of discord. So you can already hear from his tone what is sending as a signal to his people. He's saying dominate them is effectively what he's saying, because now we have a situation where Fulani herdsmen, who are effectively, whether they are Nigerians or they are from Mali or Niger or wherever, they are effectively foreigners in Yoruba land and they are effectively foreigners in Igbo land. So now you have these foreigners effectively coming into Yoruba land and Igbo land, causing an existential threat to the way of life and indeed the very life itself of the people of these regions. So now the people of these regions are now saying enough is enough. We have tried to be hospitable and we have tried to be good host, but all this raping and marauding is not really something that sits with us. It's alien to our culture. This is not how we live. So please thank you for the visit and go back to your own place of being and be there and leave us to be here. We're happy to be here by ourselves and carry on with our own way of life, and we're happy for you to be where you are and carry on with your own way of life. But this Mietiala character, this Al Hassan, has come out now in the public space again to say no, we're going to come and dominate you in your own space, because our leader, our grand patron, our life patron, because as you know, Madam Buhari is the life patron of the cattle breeders, in not just in Nigeria but in West Africa. So he has always been that long before he became president. A lot of their followings are the people who actually rigged him into power, because you will recall, of course, that there were troops coming in from Niger Republic, especially during the 2019 election. We saw all the governors of the Niger Republic coming to Kano to Buhari's rally and bringing in their troops to come and vote in Nigeria, even though Niger Republic is a foreign country. But that's a separate issue. That's for the electoral tribunals to deal with, and we all know what they are going to say at the end of that. But we saw that. So he has always been the life president, Buhari that is, of the Mietiala. So he is now the president of Nigeria, but of course his allegiance has always been to his Mietiala, because we all know that Buhari is a ethnic jingoist and religious fundamentalist. That's the one thing, or rather those are the two things that nobody really can really dispute. Not even his own wife would dispute that about Buhari. Is an ethnic jingoist and a religious fundamentalist. We all know this. Everybody knows this. So now these people now, who are also of his religion and of his ethnicity and of his mindset, have now been able to majority him into power in Nigeria, and now they want to ride roughshod over people. So looting the Niger Delta petrodollar is one thing, which is something that they just do as standard. That's just now the law in Nigeria, that the Fulanis will loot the Niger Delta oil money. So that's one thing. But then coming into Yoruba land to kill people and prevent them from going to their farms is another thing. That is a separate entity in itself. So they can ravage Sambisa Forest. Those are their own people and they can do their own thing. It's not really a concern of the Yoruba people. We're a little bit concerned about the Middle Belt, because the Middle Belt are innocent, but they've ravaged that region too. And Malam Buhari, of course, has looked away. So they are now coming into Yoruba land to come and dominate senators, and these people now who have gone to kill the daughter of our leader Parfashion Rotti are now doubling down on that position that, look, if you think this is just the end of it, then you are just a bunch of clowns. We have always known that you Yorubas are idiots. You claim that you have an education. We are here to dominate you, and dominate you we will. And this is what this guy is saying, because he has said something similar during the ravaging of the Middle Belt. You will recall when the Fulani herdsmen were ravaging the Middle Belt until they completely conquered it, and it's now become a Fulani colony, because we all know now that the Middle Belt now is a Fulani colony. When they were ravaging it and going through communities and sacking it, this same character Al-Hassan came on the it was on Channel's television actually, and he has the brazenness to say that, well, these people kill one or two of our cows, so we are going to ravage the whole of their community and their region. He said this on Channel's television. Nobody even knocked on his door, never mind the Inspector General of Police having anything to say, or the DSS, and he just walked away with it. He has Buhari's men to guard him and all whatnot, so we already know. So they've now savaged the Middle Belt, and now they are now coming into Yoruba land. But Yoruba land, of course, is always a different entity, because the one thing that holds the Nigerian nation together is the Yoruba land, because the Yoruba land believes in the Nigerian possibility, and that is why we really still have a country. So if the Yoruba land now loses that faith in the Nigerian experiment, then that is the end of that country, because the Igbos already want out anyway. So if the Yoruba now are now pushed, if the Yoruba race rather is now pushed to the point where they want out too, then there is no Nigeria left. But of course, this Fulani empty head that has a mushroom for brains, he doesn't really understand that. The only thing that they understand is the law of the sword, as they've learned from the Arabs, that is jihadi all the way, continue to behead until you get your way. That is the only understanding that he has of how the world runs. But the world does not, of course, run that way anymore. We are talking about the world of the internet now, a global community. These people don't understand anything anyway. Let me not even go into any of that. But this is now what this Malami, the cousin of Malam Buhari, has now said, that they will continue to dominate Yoruba land, as Buhari has said that his people should remain, and he's now doubling down on that as well. So this is now the language that we are now having to contend with, and this is what we will have to contend with over the next 4 years, because we are all up in arms over this unfortunate incident of the Fashion Rotti situation. But in the next 4 years, that Fashion Rotti situation will even seem like a tea party to the rest of us, because they are going to ravage and savage and brutalize all the way through. But this is something that we all know is coming anyway. So conversations in the comment section is what I am inviting. The Malamis have now fleshed out their agenda, and we are all clear in our minds now. And you have to be a certifiable moron not to understand now what is going on or what is being said. You have to be somebody that should be institutionalized in some mental place if you still don't understand now what is being said and what is going on in that country. You need somebody to supervise you in your day-to-day life. Even going to the toilet, somebody should supervise you, because you don't have function if you still claim that you don't understand now what is going on. Because the Malams have made themselves clear, and the clarity is there glaring for everybody to see. So now, conversations in the comment section is what I am inviting, as I always do. So come join me in the comment section. Come tell me what you are making of what this random empty-headed Aboki has to say. But before you come join me in the comment section to have that conversation, click on the red subscribe button so it turns gray. Bell button notifies you every time I drop a new video. Then come tell me what you are making of what the Malamis are doing within the Nigerian state in the comment section. So I leave you here. Carry on with you in the comment section. But here I say peace.